if there's no trust, how am I going to get to work? Who's going to pay for my bills? They go, trust should be considered essential service. So that's how I see it.
While thousands of Thursday morning commuters hopped on the bus to get to their destination, unionized bus drivers, sea bus operators, and maintenance workers spent part of their day at a strike vote. The union, representing over 5,000 public transit workers, says its members have been without a contract since March 31st.
Working conditions are one of the key issues in this round of negotiations. We've seen since 2016 that ridership has gone up about 18%, and at the same time, the overcrowding on the buses has increased by 36%. TransLink just won an award this summer for one of the best transit systems in North America, with on-time service being a big part of that. And what the public needs to know is that that's on the back of our members, because they don't have sufficient time to rest at the end of their shifts. And of course, wages and benefits, we want to make sure we're competitive. We want to make sure that maintenance workers under TransLink are all paid the same.
This isn't the first time Unifor and Coast Mountain Bus Company have had issues getting a deal done. In April of 2016, unionized public transit workers voted 98% in favor to strike. But job action never happened, and a three-year deal was eventually agreed upon in the summer. The last time drivers did walk off the job was in 2001, during a nasty four-month transit strike in Metro Vancouver.
You know, the traffic has increased phenomenally. Drivers are more stressed out. Running times are very, very tight. And it's just not a good situation to put a professional drivers like we are supposed to be in that situation.
You've been driving for a bit of time in the seat, and you've come to the end, and there's not a lot of time that's there to go, you know, the bathroom and you know, maybe get something to eat, get some water, kind of clear your mind space, because a lot of the driving is a lot of that portion is a mental piece. So sometimes it's nice just to get out of the seat and just get some air.
In a statement to City News, Coast Mountain Bus Company says the parties have now stepped away from the bargaining table to determine their next steps. CMBC does not anticipate any disruption to service at this time. CMBC remains committed to reaching an acceptable negotiated settlement. Broadway and Commercial, a very busy hub for public transit in the city of Vancouver. And I can tell you there's a lot of bus riders here right now that are a little nervous about where things sit.
I'm very concerned how I'm gonna get to work.
I'm super nervous. Like, I don't know, like, school is, like, really important. Like, I need to, like, get up the hill. I need to get up that mountain to get to school, so.
Now my family cannot afford a car. If the bus system shuts off, then I'll be in trouble.
I hope they work something out fast.
It's not fair. It seems like every time it's our turn to bargain, we get thrown under the bus, and it's just not fair.
In Vancouver, Greg Harper, City News.